Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to create a pivot table from more than one worksheet in Microsoft Excel. So here in our example, we have data from the East on the East tab, data from the West on the West tab, and we've combined them all into one pivot table right here on the Combine One tab. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. Let's start with a blank worksheet. In this case, it is the Combine One worksheet that we just saw the pivot table on, because this is where we are going to put the pivot table. First, in order to do this, we're going to need access to the pivot table wizard. So with the standard setup of Microsoft Excel, the pivot table wizard doesn't exist on any of your ribbons. And if you do a search up here, it's kind of hard to find. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this button right here that says Customize Quick Access Toolbar. It's got a down arrow with a line over it. So if I click that and go to More Commands, right here where it says Popular Commands, I'm going to click that and select All Commands. And then I can scroll down to the P's, but as you can see, that's going to take a while. So I'm just going to click in here, and I'm going to quickly type PIV. And I'm going to be taken to all of the pivot chart options. So right here, I'm looking for Pivot Table and Pivot Chart Wizard. So I'm going to click on that and say Add, and then click OK. And now I can see that this button has appeared up here.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So now from my blank worksheet, if I just go up here and click this button, I can see that the pivot table and pivot chart wizard has started. So what I want to do here is I want to select multiple consolidation ranges, and I want this to end up in a pivot table. So I'm going to click next. And on my second screen, I'm presented with two options. How many page fields do you want? I'm going to select I will create the page fields and then click next. And now I'm being prompted for a range. So I'm going to click this up arrow here, and then I'm going to go to East, and I'm going to start clicking in A1, hold my left mouse button down and drag to B1 and drag all the way to the bottom and let go. And then I'm going to click this box again. And then I'm going to click Add. And then for another one that I want to consolidate, I'm going to click this up arrow again. I'm going to go to West. I'm going to left click on A1, hold my mouse button down, drag to B1, and drag to the bottom here. And click this button again and say Add. Then I'm going to select East at the top, click 1. In field 1, I'm going to call East. And then on West, I'm going to click this option, keep field 1, and then I'm going to type West. And then I'm going to click Next. And this is going to ask me where I want to put my new pivot table. So since I'm already on my new worksheet, I can put it in A3, which is what Excel is suggesting, and I'm just going to go with that. You could also have Excel create a new worksheet and select this option up here if you would like. But for me, since I started on the blank worksheet, on Combine One, I'm just going to keep that option checked and then hit Finish. And now I can see if I scroll down that my pivot table has been combined. So how do I know that this has actually been combined? Well, let's look at 9-1. If I go to East on 9-1, I have a sale amount of 404. But if I go to West on 9-1, I have a sale amount of 452. So 452 plus 404 would be 856. So if I go to my combine, I can see the 856 right here. So I can see that both of these pivot tables are being combined into this sale amount right here. There's also another way to do this in Power Query, and we go into that option a little more on our blog, and I'm going to include that link below in the description on YouTube if you would like to visit there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.